Good morning, everyone, and welcome to St. John United Church of Christ in Bellevue, Kentucky. And as we say every Sunday that we gather here, no matter who you are or where you are in life's journey, you are welcome here. Thank you for joining us through the internet today. Christ Church, United Church of Christ in Fort Thomas, First Presbyterian Church in Fort Thomas, St. John United Church of Christ in Bellevue, and St. John's United Church of Christ in Newport, all work together in these efforts to reach out to you virtually for worship on Sunday. And we're so glad that if you're a part of one of those congregations, we're so glad that you joined us today. If you're not a part of any of those congregations or any congregation anywhere else, we're glad that you have tuned in, and we hope that this will be helpful and a blessing to you.
This is the day of joyous welcome.
We welcome Christ with waving palm branches.
Our leader comes humbly riding a donkey.
Blessed is the one who comes in God's name.
Jesus rides into the tumult of our lives. People still oppose the way of love. Yet love prevails despite opposition.
Give thanks that God's steadfast love endures forever.
Open to us the gates of righteousness.
Let us unite together to worship in God's light. Good morning, everyone. Today is Palm Sunday. Do you remember what happened on Palm Sunday? Jesus rode into Jerusalem. Did he ride in on a limo or a float? No, he came in on a donkey. Not a big fancy horse, but a donkey, which is just a work animal. By coming in on a donkey, Jesus was doing something that a prophet from the Old Testament had predicted long ago, long before he was even born. It showed God was following through on his big plans. Now, while Jesus was coming into Jerusalem, people lined up to welcome him. They waved palm branches, sort of like you might wave a flag at a big parade. The palm branches showed celebration and were a sign of victory. The people wanted Jesus to bring victory and good things. While they were celebrating, the people lining the path also shouted something. Do you remember what it was? They hollered, "Hosanna." Hosanna means save us. The people wanted Jesus to save them, and they expected that he would be able to do it. Jesus did come to save, but it was not exactly the way the folks anticipated. The people in Jerusalem thought he was going to be an earthly king and save them from the people who were mistreating them. He wasn't saving them from political leaders, but he was saving them and in a much better way. You know, sometimes we want to put our own expectations on Jesus too. Maybe we have an idea of how we think he should answer our prayers or work in our lives. We get confused or upset when God's way doesn't look just the way we thought it would. But we can be assured that God has much bigger plans in mind. Our job is to continue following him. We want to proclaim the amazing works of Jesus and tell everyone how wonderful he is. Hosanna. Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for your work in our lives, even in unexpected ways. Help us to always praise your name. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for your son, Jesus. In his name we pray. Amen.
My name is Melissa Stevens. I'm the treasurer at St. John United Church of Christ in Bellevue. And you know what? I'm a little sad. I'm missing my choir friends, the camaraderie we have, the beautiful music we made. You know, I'm also a little mad. When I heard that lawmakers were selling off their stock, and then I looked at my retirement portfolio and I see it tanking, it makes me furious. And I'm a little afraid. I'm afraid I don't want to get sick. And I just don't have any idea how to imagine the impact this is going to have on our lives when it's resolved, how different our lives will be. It's a difficult time. So I have a choice. I can be mad, sad, and afraid, and I can react out of that emotion. I can hoard toilet paper. I can withhold. I can cower in fear. Or I can be faithful. And the truth is, I want to choose to be faithful. I want to continue to believe that I worship a great big God who has me my church congregation, our shared future in God's sight, and that we're all going to be okay. And when I believe that, I can react faithfully. I can continue to support St. John with my contributions, as my husband John and I have done. And I hope you will too. I hope you will continue to the best of your ability to continue to support your worshiping congregation. And you can continue to pray, for that is the power that we have. And you can continue to attend worship. We welcome you this morning to Palm Sunday. And next Sunday is Easter, the day that we remember that it's not about this life anyway. So I pray that you will be faithful and continue to support your congregation with your finances, with your faith, with your prayers, and that you will find peace in knowing that God's got it.
Our scripture reading for this Palm Sunday comes from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 21, verses 1 through 11. When they had come near Jerusalem and had reached Bethphage at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go into the village ahead of you. Immediately you will find a donkey tied and a colt with her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, just say this: the Lord needs them, and he will send them immediately." This took place to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet, saying, "Tell the daughter of Zion, look, your king is coming to you, humble and mounted on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey." So the disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and put their cloaks on them, and he sat on them. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds went ahead of him, and those that followed were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest heaven!" And when Jesus had entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil. They were asking, "Who is this?" And the crowds were saying, "This is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
He is King of Kings, he is Lord.
Houston Hall. I'm the interim minister at St. John in Newport. Let us pray. Christ, we pray that you would hear our prayers and graft in our mind and the same mind that is in you, that we might be vessels of your humility and grace. Jesus, you emptied yourself, trading in the form of God for the form of a slave. We pray for the church and all her people and ministers. Form us into a church that empties itself for others and for you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Jesus was born in human likeness and found in human form. We pray for the whole human family, for the nations of the earth, and for all who live in the midst of disaster, famine, or terror. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Jesus, even after humbling yourself in your incarnation, you humbled yourself even to the point of death. We pray for our nation, our leaders, and for all people who live within these borders. Bless us with your humility. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Jesus, your humility and your love for us was so broad and so deep, it cost you your life. We pray for those who we love, who have died, and as you have highly exalted, may they rest in your glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In your exaltation, O Lord, you were given the name that is above every name. We pray in your name for those who are poor, those who are hungry, those who are hurting in any way. Give them your grace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We also pray in your name, O Lord, for those who are sick. Give them the gift of healing and strength and life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all the concerns we carry this day. Give them the gift of healing, strength, and life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You humbled yourself in the manger, and you humbled yourself on the cross. And to you, O Lord, we bend our knee with those above and those below, to the glory of God the Creator. Amen. And together we say the words that our Savior has taught us to say. Loving God, in whom in heaven, may your name be honored everywhere. May your kingdom come. May the desires of your heart for the world to be done in us, by us, and through us. Give us the bread that we need for each day. Forgive us. Enable us to forgive others. Keep us from all anxiety and fear. For you reign in the power that comes from above, which is your glory forever and ever. Amen.
I love Palm Sunday. It is a great celebration of the church today, with palms being lifted and waving in the air, banners embroidered with the word Hosanna, processing down the aisles, proclaiming its meaning. We beseech you to save us. Hosanna, save us, O God. All of this attempting to depict that first Palm Sunday, a few days before the Jewish Passover festival, an event that meant that the streets of the city of Jerusalem would be full of people flocking in from the countryside, while others made the journey from foreign places to add to the crowds. Jerusalem was buzzing. The Roman authorities, with extra officers, centurions, and soldiers, helped to ensure there would be no trouble in the city during Passover. They were marching into the city in broad daylight, in full military parade, with equipment and finery and bristling with armor and weapons, in order to remind the Jewish people who was really in charge. This is a rather ironic occasion, because the Passover festival is when the people of Israel remembered and celebrated their deliverance from slavery in Egypt. The military presence basically said, you can have your festival, but Rome is the new Egypt, and Caesar is the new Pharaoh. Back at the ranch, you might say, Jesus is trying to figure out how to get on a donkey and her colt at the same time for the parade with his followers coming in the other side of town. We may not like to admit it in 2020, but Jesus is and was a radical spiritual leader who teaches simplicity, peace, integrity, community, and equality. That message irritated, provoked, and challenged the authority of the empire of Rome with its power and its politics and oppression to the poor and the outcast. Picture it. The Roman Empire authorities and soldiers marching in on one side of town with horses and chariots and armor and military might. And then on the other side, Jesus processes in with his followers, paving his way with palms and cloaks and branches, not on a war horse, but rather on a humble creature of peace, a donkey and her colt. On one side of town, a kingdom that uses words like army, soldier, centurion, regiment. On the other side of town, a kingdom that uses words like brother, sister, orphan, widow, family. Although I love the memories of my childhood Palm Sundays, that first Palm Sunday was the day Jesus went to the streets for the sake of the poor and the outcast who barely survived under Rome's empire. Philip Gully says, if God has a preference for the poor and powerless, and Scripture certainly suggests that to be the case, then the poor must also receive the bulk of our attention and our resources. This past week for me was when the deep realities of this pandemic began to sink into my soul. And this was a time when I realized yet again how privileged I am as I sat in my comfortable chair in my comfortable home. It kept coming to me, how are we going to take care of the people in need? We have all heard the words unprecedented, overwhelming, catastrophic, but even these words do not seem to describe this pandemic. And most importantly, we know that behind these words are people. People with unmet food, financial, and housing needs. People with anxiety and addictions and mental health needs. People in need of comfort for the grief of lost loved ones. How will we, the church, take care of the people in need? I usually include a quote in our congregation's publication each week. And this week, a man in my congregation sent me a quote. His name is Jim Palm, pretty appropriate for Palm Sunday. He shared this quote with me considering COVID-19. It says, our churches are not empty. Our churches have been deployed. Jesus' message of love, peace, and grace was and is a threat to empires, and it always will be. Jesus was public with his message. He didn't slip into town without being seen. He came to the capital with a dramatic counter demonstration. He came to answer the people's plea, "Hosanna, save us." His way was their answer, and it is our answer too. Jesus went to the streets for God's kingdom, God's way of love, peace, and grace. I'm sure that the oppressive Roman Empire felt just overwhelming to Jesus and his followers. And perhaps just as COVID-19 seems overwhelming to us. Yes, we are being asked to be physically distant from one another and to stay home, and that's important. We all need to be doing that. But that doesn't mean that we can't be deployed to the streets with Jesus. Like me, perhaps you have sat in your homes over the past several weeks and watched the COVID-19 updates from 3 governors and numerous national leaders. And as I hear the reports and the predictions each night, I think of those who are without a home all around us right here in Northern Kentucky. Unemployed, underemployed, or without the means to live beyond one paycheck. And I am so grateful for so many organizations locally on the front lines helping people who are hit the hardest by this pandemic. As the church, we are invited to the streets with Jesus, to walk with people in need. Now you might be thinking to yourself, it sounds like he's going to ask us for money for all of those organizations. And note that I have not asked, but maybe the Holy Spirit is asking. As you wave your virtual palms today, as you sing Hosanna, a plea to be saved, remember that you are the church, that we are the church, and we journey the way of Jesus. We deploy to the streets for the kingdom of love, peace, and grace. Amen.
Filled with excitement, all the happy throng spread cloaks and branches on the city streets. There in the distance they begin to see. There on a donkey comes the Savior Christ. From every corner a thousand voices sing. Praise to the one who comes in the name of God. Our acclamation breaks forth in shouts of praise. Our triumphant song of joy.
Now may the living Christ go with you, before you to light the way, behind you to encourage you, beside you to befriend you, beneath you to sustain you, above you to watch over you, and within you to give you peace. Go and serve God faithfully. Amen.